Hello everyone and welcome back to ACW. Now, last time I uploaded a video, it was probably this Saturday. We finished the Napoleon campaign. We didn't finish it the old school way. Can you even put it that way? I don't know. We didn't finish it the legit way. I had my own standards and my own goals. So I said simply, let's burn Berlin and finish the wars. And I had no wars ongoing. And I did, in fact, end it by also taking London and then freeing them, so the most of you British people should be rather satisfied with that. Even though, you know, when you're playing games like this, don't look back on it and say, oh, you bloody bastard, you burnt me country. You know, but see, you know, in a fun way. Anyways, I'm glad to be back, hence why I'm so energetic. And that, well, that generally is a good basis for a good episode. But, yes, the only solution for me actually winning this war is for me to actually send in my armies and push in for it. I can't sit back and just wait. They're not going to move. I'm not going to move theoretically as well, so I think it's time for us to push in. And all of these armies are actually going to be dispatched this way. Some of them are actually going to be moving back up again. The income is great. Surprise, surprise. And what more could you actually ask for? Send these guys that way. And, I mean, we're welcome to recruit, you know, shit on them. I'm going to get these with words cannon. I want them in the field of battle. And that should be about it. So, I want to do a British campaign. So I can, like, shout, like, 90 second, present the class, or whatever. They shout, and Picton's like, move, be gone, damn your eyes, or something. I can't remember it fully. You should watch Waterloo. That's actually where they say it. It's a very cool movie. Got tons of cool things in it. But, yeah, I'm a bit pissed that Napoleon didn't win the Napoleonic Wars, if we're going to actually end to talk about something that's more Napoleonic related now that we finished the campaign. He should have burnt Berlin, and the Prussians shouldn't have showed up in May. Well, I guess there's many factors, and you can't really blame it on the French themselves. The British fought well, along with the Prussians, that arrived a bit late. But, you know, should have won or should have not have won. It's like saying that Germany should have won World War II. They didn't. You can always look back and say they should have won. But we have to actually stick to what actually happened and live with that. Even though I'm pretty satisfied of my own life today. I don't say we're not living under, like, British tyranny and after they won the Napoleonic Wars. So you can kind of compare the French to Hitler at the time. Napoleon. Maybe he wasn't, you know, trying to exterminate people and he didn't have the same sort of anti-Semitic thoughts and ideas. But you know, he was still, a dictator, kind of his own age. He conquered many areas and, you know, did a lot of horrible things. So, you know, history always repeats itself, though. But you can never really, really compare anyone to Napoleon. Not even, you know, can't really do that. It's a shame. And, but I think that ends it. I really loved it, and I do want to do a British campaign from the beginning again. That time, I'll probably play it on very hard, as I do love the extra challenge. And I'm still cold, by the way, as you might have noticed. And this is taking forever. And it also just would be awesome. So that's going to be done. I'm also going to do a stainless steel let's play once I get stainless steel working. I'm also starting a new warband let's play, so as I'm... What I want to do first person films, you know, something that's third slash first person, which would be very good. And if you're wondering why I didn't upload no videos, it's simply because I didn't have internet. And now I do, hopefully. Well, of course I do. I did switch out my router for the newest one, so that should be good. Anyhow, here we are. Talk ended perfectly in time. Battle of the Crater. The Confederate approach Washington, D.C. Ah, it's gone that far, has it now? Anyhow, what should we do? I think we'll pull in these with words and these armies here. March. Just divide them in there nicely.
Make ready.
Waiting further order.
Mark.
Just in you go. More? And the Confederate army has grown insanely. Here's one full stack army, one and a half.
Yes.
This here makes four,
yes.
Two full stacked armies, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and probably 10, with the rest of the lot that I've got just running around somewhere. So, it's looking pretty G right now, I have to say. And I think it's time, as I previously stated,
sir,
to attack. He
sir.
Will be sent up. March. He will be sent there. Yes. They will be forward. Dedicated for march. This. This corps will be moving up. Impossible. So, we've got two armies heading up.
Yes, sir.
We're going to send these a bit ready. Closer. Onward. Without actually sir. Initiating an attack.
Order,
I want all my forward. Units. There we go. Is this the fight that I wanted? Clearly, this is an even fight. And it actually might not even... it looks like...
beat the retreat.
Fuck, alright.
Yes.
Okay, I'll stay back for now. It's something tells me that... Where are they gathering the troops from? Have they got tons of people hiding here? It could be because I'm all coming in from that direction. I don't know. We need to do some
planning
more research
your construction
on that.
Needs is essential to a
see if I can actually
empire.
Just get some...
Buildings
extra troops out just before the battle.
The research and acquisition
you know, volunteer infantry with two in ranks? They're not bad. They're not bad. Not at all. No. Well, we're up for another long turn, but I might be able to pay the British and get them to attack the Americans from the top. Wouldn't that be like the final vengeance? Like, you know, after all, like, they've been through during the 1700s and 1800s and, you know, just... Generally, that kind of North and South Korea feeling. I wouldn't know, though, as I'm not from any other countries. But I don't know. I wouldn't be so happy if it, you know. I explained myself. But that'd be funny if they just get like a final backstab. I think we're gonna pick this fight, though, as we clearly do have the upper hand. They didn't see my other armies. Other armies. Got the Irish Brigade. Got some Cav. Got some Arty. Yeah, I'm gonna save this. Got a feeling that I might crash, but hopefully not, as I have done everything to prevent crashing. Hopefully my PC doesn't sound too much either. It's actually running extremely cold right now, which is good, of course. I wonder if I click this thing here, will that make for a more noisy thing? Hear the fans? Pretty sure you can. This is a dust filter. It's got barely any dust in it, so I'll leave it up. Chocolate from Disney next to me as well. What's this? Choco Fun. Schokolin Sentafel. Chocolat. Oh, it's German. And French. Chocolat au lait avec dragé au chocolat. Okay, I could probably pronounce it wrong. I can't even see what it says. And then it's got Cicciolatte al latte con confetti di cocciolato. Oh, I don't even know. And the music's repeating itself.
Straight line of units is not always the best for.
Hello. Where am I? Alright. First of all, credits to this battlefield. Thank you, God, for placing us here in this beautiful battlefield. Stretch these mofos out here. I think I'll leave, perhaps not the whole Irish Brigade. That wasn't the whole Irish Brigade, but... Okay, we'll take some of these unexperienced noobs. Put them here by the fence. And then we'll put these batteries out there. And then we'll take some of the, also, some more noobs. Set them out here in a double line on the sides, and then like a... kind of more like a triple line in the center. Center company? That really doesn't have any meaning, though, center company. It's the game volume loud. I feel completely overvoiced. Could be just the music. Probably it's just the music. I really do hate when you have to configure sound settings forever, because usually it takes a shitload of time. Put two regular Confederate battalions on the right here. I know they're not battalions, but... You know, battalion would be like more like 500, 600 men, depending on how many men you actually had in the regiments of the time. I mean, it depends from country and country. Like, some countries would have, like, just 500 men in a regiment. Some would have, like, you know, barely anything. And then you would have, all suddenly, 24 battalions in a regiment. Or, not regiment, but more like a division. 24 battalions, that's pretty much 12,000 men, which is pretty much a Commonwealth division of its time. Makes pretty much sense. We'll have these two here as reserves if we're going to be needing them. We'll put another dude over here. Another two dudes over there. One for the flanking protection and one for the reserve up here.
Deploying
and
your infantry.
Now we'll
war.
Just let the artillery do the main part of the job. Union boys, I've missed you. 101st Union Militia,
forward!
42nd Volunteers. Iron Brigade right here. 84th Union Sharpshooters. 34th, 109th, 44th. Low numbers. I mean, at least it's not like a 1,005th or something like that. Tend to mean that they're rather experienced. If you'd find like the 2nd Regiment of Foot Volunteers, they've most likely been around from the beginning, unless the game just randomly picks, you know. Alright, so that was a pretty devastating barrage there. I'm gonna spread these guys out a bit more to kind of reduce the risk of taking more casualties. I'm gonna put the cavalry on the right, left flank, sorry, my left, they're right. Make sure there's not a lacking of connections here. It's pretty thick on this flank, so I think we're gonna do this. Gonna send these guys up that way, and have these guys in reserve over there. As long as they're double lines and a bit more than that, take or add, take or give, probably. And it's pretty good. So what, are we bombarding them or what? Hit the Iron Brigade. They are kind of the people you don't really want to fight. But personally, I wouldn't want to fight the Iron Brigade. I mean, they're named Iron Brigade. I mean, it's on one regiment. The Iron Brigade's like a brigade of three. The 14th Brooklyn, East Iron Brigade. The 24th Michigan, I believe. Or the 28th Michigan. Something like that. Along with those lines. Then there was also the Excelsior Brigade, the Irish Brigade, which contained the 63rd, Irish, 88th, not 63rd Irish, 63rd, 69th, and 88th. 88th, which had its name from the 88th Connaught Rangers, I believe. I mean, why would they not pick the 88th, since it was an Irish regiment in the Napoleonic Wars? It could have, could not have, I don't know. Okay, so I think while these guys are under fire, let's see what have we got for... too much cav. I'm just gonna ride in and see what kind of damage I can get. Because right now they're under fire. If they, you know, come under... Wait a minute. I think actually deploying and shooting could have been a wiser idea. We've killed many enemy generals at the moment. Looks like we're winning the firefights here. Okay, you hold fire because you were about to fire.
Flashing unit banner means the morale of their troops is wavering.
Let's get him, guys. Let's get him, boys.
Break from yeehaw! And rout from the field. Take this opportunity to charge their ranks with cavalry or infantry.
Here comes the cavalry brigade.
Fixed. The battle is over when all troops
the Michigan
in the
division
are routed or killed.
Probably him. With cavalry. They're shooting here and here. Here comes the Lissa charging in here, and these guys are just, I don't know, they're not firing yet, but they will be pretty soon. Gonna bring these guys up to reinforce this line. My brigades need protect. Oh shit, Savi's coming up the center. This is gonna be a nice battle, guys. It's gonna be nasty to begin with. As it, well, already is. As you hopefully can tell. It's gruesome. So here, our cavalry is doing a pretty good job, but now they're gonna get freaking attacked from the flanks. This is. Once again, why you need to pay attention and. Why I once again failed to do so when recording. Okay, we're gonna retreat these guys behind here quickly. If you may, please. Please, go. I think I'm gonna ride up with these guys in front of the rest. Oh, poor bastards are caught off guard. Well. Redirect fire. Yes, sir. Redirecting fire. Okay, you guys will animate into... Wait a second. No, you're too thin on the snipes, so we can't do it like that. This is nice, this is really nice, this should scare the Union forces away as we got another 300 men up here. That's a battalion, down in size a bit. Definitely good though, three companies moving up. Artillery's pounding, and we should be doing the same right now. Okay, let me see here. Here we go, guys. This is looking absolutely fantastic. Oh, there we go. Nice volley. Let's get him, boys. Let's get him, boys. God, I've missed this. Missed the rattle from the muskets. I think the right flank is pretty clean. I think the left side here is going to need some reinforcements. Looks like the enemy's got... Oops, I should have noticed this. Did not. My bad. Mount fixed bayonet. Do it as fast as you can. Let's bring these guys up here as well. Quickly screen off from these guys. Put these guys on shooting, and then we're going to see here. We can take this line, turn it around that way. Okay, counter charge. We got bayonets, and they're regulars, so I don't see that they're Union cavalry. They shouldn't have, like, an extreme upper hand. On we go, lads. Come on. Haven't got all day. Okay, these guys are going to move up here. I don't think we'll need any flanking on this part. Looks like we're having a slight problem here. And I do think it's worth simply doing like this. We do when I get them in the shooting. Let's bring up these guys. That's a total of 3 companies. And these guys will just proceed to take their spot. These guys are still putting fire on them. Looking pretty good. We have yet to receive reinforcements, and lovely enough, they're coming in from this amazing position up here. We've yet to see where the enemy reinforcements will be coming in from. Looks like they're going to be receiving them from this direction. I am correct. We just lost one of our generals. Could be a captain, could be the other. We probably won't know until we actually take a closer look at it. Looks like the bayonet equipment... Ah, these were 3. Never mind. Well, I think it's, you know, the best thing you could do at this point is put as much pressure on the enemy as possible right off the start. So we're going to bring all these columns here into kind of an aggressive position where we can shoot further and pin more. I'll limber over here, make sure that these guys are caught. They're losing their way. Let's get these guys on the run as well. Oh, they're broken. Well, well, well. Shattered and broken. Better than both broken. There's no time to waste. We should be arriving with some more troops pretty soon. These guys are just fearsomely just firing as much as they can right now. Gonna get those guys set up there. We're gonna have these guys open fire on them. They're gonna pin these guys for as long as they can, and while we charge in with the bayonets. Mini guns! Oh, Gatling guns are arriving on the battlefield, and not, well, in quite a, pirate rifles as well. Pretty nasty here in open terrain, but they're probably gonna do more damage to their own units than ours right now.
If your line infantry are about to be chopped.
On we go, lads. Let's give him some fire. How could you almost waver? Is this piece of cake? Okay, let's... Can artillery still... No, I think it's time to move these guys up. I think we're gonna put them back here and bring these battalions up there. I hope you're enjoying the video, guys. It's very fun at the moment. I feel very energetic. And we're mounting up these cannons now. Let's see here, the third has arrived. Ah, well, that's a pretty low number. They haven't seen much though yet. It could have been one of those units I've just had randomly casually sticking with me for the last couple of turns. Let's bring the artillery up here to a good position. Looks like we chased them off. Better retreat my bayonet mounted.
Killing their general will deliver
51st
a
is here.
Well,
the
enemy army's morale
not
the
51st that you're probably thinking of. Oh, wait a minute. Don't tell me they're winning.
Enemy cavalry charging towards your flank. Turn.
I think no. Okay, let's just bring these guys up here. That should make them round as soon as we get there. Let's bring these guys up too. These howitzers have definitely not got the adequate range, so mount up with that as well. Charge. Are we losing slightly? Oh, dear God. That's Meade. Meade. Ah. Why is he wearing a Confederate uniform? Or is that just me? Could be just me. Maybe he fancied the gray. Alright, so these guys have they're shaken. They haven't yet retreated, but they're pulling back, which is a wise choice. Oh my God, I can't face this army off right now. The Union are too strong, but we are bringing up more battalions. We got the 119th and 94th Confederate volunteers coming in here. Let's say these guys are from Georgia. Yeah, moving in there, and we got the artillery on the way as well. Hopefully he should be dying soon, which he isn't, unfortunately. Okay, this is cheesy as hell. Okay, but nonetheless, it looks like we do have some company up here. I think it's time to just start raining all over them. They're pretty fresh though, so you never know what you can expect from their performance. They've got new rounds, they're all full health. I haven't, you know, barely brought in anything from my proper core yet. It looks like they're going on the offensive, or if I don't get up the cannons up in time, it's going to be costly, so I'm going to deploy them here in the woods. Hopefully that shouldn't affect the shooting too much. Got these guys broken. The Vedette Cavalry is going to probably charge into my Bayonet-equipped infantry that's already seen some combat, so I don't know if that's the smartest thing it'll show. Shows that it is at the moment. God damn it. It's here. Okay. Okay, we got them running over here. Now, here's it's gonna be some kind of epic wall defense, you know, that stuff. Oh, this is just gonna be a clusterfuck right here for this artillery on the side here. This just went out of hand instantly, to say the least. Let's get these guys in position over there, and let's bring these guys up over here. I wouldn't want to, you know, see the Union boys flanking me. I'm going to make a straight line of approach right there. Got these guys coming in. Going to put the artillery right there. Not on the high ground, but just right there. Let's hear. Breaking off here and there, it looks like the 69th. Or that's not the 69th Irish. Oh my God. They broke off everything right here. Looks like I have to take into the make use of the shrapnel. Okay, it's pretty bad. It's pretty bad. Okay, we should get them routing as well with a couple of more volleys. They're very unfocused. Oh wow, the whole fucking brigade's retreating. What's going on? Looks like I have to make a new stand over here. You guys deploy right here. Retreat. Get the artillery going now. We're gonna need a lot of reinforcements. This battle has only just begun right now. It's proven to be, I think it's gonna be one of the more interesting battles of this season. No, this is a TV series right now going on HBO or the History Channel, which would be, I don't know. I don't know if the History Channel would show this kind of stuff. I mean, it was done well enough. I presume they wouldn't mind having a bit of a machinima in it. Like, machinima itself is just generally movies or cinematics made with video games or software. Looks like we don't have a decent shot at all over here, and looks like this whole core just broke off. I don't know why. I mean, I guess the Union said that when theirs did. They've really reformed here. I'm hoping to be able to hold them off with a new line here and with the support of artillery. It's going to prove to be extremely difficult as none of my units are actually out of the field yet. So I might be just taken or caught on my bed, as it's called, which I really hope to be able to avoid, as it tends to be. Probably it's just going to end up in a massacre. 164. I want to see below 150 after you guys fire next time. You're 82. Not hitting jack shit army here? Don't think so, sir. Taking shots everywhere. Shattered and wavering. Come on, guys. Ah, they're done for. We've entered the third phase of the battle. The first phase was the big fight. The second phase was when we were moving up here on the right. And third has begun over here now. This is what I really enjoy by having smaller units. I don't really care about having like 40 units in an army. This is, you know, perfect unit sizes and the perfect amount of troops in the battle right now. And who knows, I think we're gonna see a lot of dead people by the end of the day. Which, I don't know, tends to get people excited. We're holding here though, we're winning slightly as well, and you know, the strength and the support of artillery. Did a guy just randomly get shot back here? You know, this is just constantly firing on the Union with extreme success. It's not extreme success, it's over the top. But I believe they're going in now as well. So here, sound charge. Hold, 52nd, 71st, 92nd, and 3rd. Hold! Regiments during that time would generally not exceed numbers of 90, I'm pretty sure. There was probably like the 101st, 111th, I recognize the 111th, but depending on what state you came from and what side you were on, I mean, you're obviously not going to find 100 regiments from Alaska. So, I don't even think Alaska was included during the war, but you get my logic. Come on, guys, hold! Hold! Oh my god, that's really brutal. They're losing right now. Hold, just the 50 seconds wavering. The right side's wavering. Hold, lads, hold. We got reinforcements on the way, hold. They're coming in men, guys, they're coming in men. We've got the experience and the balls to stand and fight. You will not fail me now. Hold! Hold! This is just truly epic right now. Cavalry on the side! What's up? Oh, right in the center. Oh, yes. Okay, got artillery coming in from this side, which is a bit ambitious. I guess we're just starting over again then, I presume. Got two regiments over here, 116th and 151st. I was expecting one of those other hundreds. Our flank's gonna die out now completely. I think it's time to just mount bayonets for the whole lot. And just charge, you know. Charge! They fought bravely. Ah, well, look at this. If it wouldn't be MacDougall's Corps from Derbader, or whatever I said last time. Well, they're welcome to attend this battle today. I am actually glad to have him here. I never thought I'd say that about MacDougall's Corps. I mean, we all know that MacDougall's Corps didn't do so well in the battle for, I don't know, some town somewhere. And, but you know, they're still decent. They have yet to prove them so to be as good as I hope they are. But yeah, it'll be interesting to say the least. Shrapnel artillery. Just gonna rain down on Buford's cavalry right there. Should be interesting. And we fire? No? We no fire? Okay. Oh, fucking idiots. I guess they're just gonna skip my artillery though. I think they're gonna go straight for the line here. It's a suicide run. Oh, nice. 156. Come on. Just a couple more shots. Oh, yeah. Give him. Give him it. Yes. Ooh. Fire. Ooh. Yes. That didn't really kill too many, but it was beautiful. Okay, they're getting in on our flanks. What the hell you do to me? Dude, what the hell? Okay, I hate when they have to flank.
There is often an advantage in ordering your
always, like,
to
get a flank. Oh, I've got a flank.
The trick is to leave it until the last moment, so your own lines are not broken.
Oh, this is brilliant, though. They're just going to take their place, as these guys are going to proceed to open fire. Oh, this is a brilliant. MacDougall's Corps is doing brilliant right now, sir. MacDougall's Corps is... Oh, my God, MacDougall's artillery got a fire down there. Man, that would be so sweet. How's it looking on this flank? We've got some regiments coming up here. I think we're just gonna unlimber here, shoot at them, take these guys, and shoot at them as well. How's it going? They're winning, sir. Can't allow that, can we? Nope. It's So you're gonna have to mount bayonet. Oh, this is gonna go down quick. McDougal's corps just might just wither away. From what I've seen, they're winning right now. Okay, these are Suaves. If they get in melee here, we might see a whole different story of develop. Oh god, this is nasty. I believe we got the right or the left flank on our side, so to say. Definitely have an upper hand in this. Okay. Okay, we gotta move on, I think we should be able to fire above their heads if we're standing on this position. They're not yet retreating. They're still combat winning. There's only... Oh, there we go. Shattered. These guys might return. They are returning. Good. Okay. They're fully bayonet fixed infantry right now, so... Probably won't make the best out of it. But we'll try. Hold there. Artillery, can you still fire? Yes, you can. Actually got pretty good... Got a pretty good clearing in them. Oh, yeah. The whole Union Center is breaking off right now. Really, really, really did pay off to do as I did. Okay, we're gonna bring these guys up as well. Oh my god, McDougal score. What the hell? Man, you're so big, man. I can't even put you all. Do some shooting, and these guys are gonna go around the flank. Oh, I got pretty good. Ah, well, look, it didn't die. The 2nd Regiment of Cavalry. You bloody. Bloody late. Well, they're always gonna be late. McDougal's corps, never gonna be in time. Ever, never. Never happened, never will happen. Losing slightly, what is this? Is this a joke? And you're all just gonna rain down hell on them. You're just shooting over their heads, so. No casualties. This is a pretty cool scene right here. Like cavalry riding in between, shooting over each other's heads and all that. Once we're done with these guys, 41st, which we are just about now, and we shoot some round shot at these bastards running away, it's time for us to just mount up and attack and move forward. Guys have reserves back there on the right. Cavalry just randomly ran in without me even seeing it. Oh man, yeah man, kill two of those men. Get the Union militia. Union engineers, probably not the strongest against cavalry, but I'm sure so I'm not gonna send them in. I told you to attack the. Yeah, there we go. Alright, you fucking wankers. If you don't beat them, I'll beat you. Okay, they are. Should be pretty fine. Considering they've got Terry Texas Rangers. And now the general's like, no, hold. The whole brigade cannot retreat. We gotta reform and defend. This is a long battle. Pizza. But it's gonna be a damn long fight. And I love it. I love it. Hey. Alright, these guys are broken. Let's go with the 51st. How are these guys feeling today? They're losing slightly, but I wouldn't say that my men are doing a majority of the job. Artillery's doing okay. So three units from this side is going to come up on the right and do some good damage. Help us out pretty well. Okay, you guys are lazy just standing there shooting. Mount up the artillery. Let's form a big line of attack. And then just push forward. See what's that. 54th Massachusetts. But there's still the 29th. That doesn't make any sense. That's why I want them to have state infantry. Like, first, like, you know, so all the regiments would just be created after state. It wouldn't be like, you wouldn't be purchasing regular or volunteer infantry. You'd purchase like Maine infantry, and they'd look slightly different. You'd purchase Michigan infantry, New York infantry, and then they had like the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, all that. Oh god, mate, please make it in time. Yes. You were lucky, because if the Massachusetts would have been shooting, you would well be dead. We wouldn't want any of that. Okay, regular infantry can stand my cavalry. They hate it. gonna bring everything up. Miniguns are shooting, but, well, not really doing a majority of... Killed like two people. That's alright. Better than nothing. These guys are still standing. Like, this is the Iron Brigade or something? They, you know, what the hell? Okay, that is the weirdest angling I've ever seen in my whole entire life as a military commander. You could not have angled it any better. Please. And our artillery is just like doing their best. These guys are still winning. They're standing. What the hell is wrong, man? 116th. Weren't they the ones that landed from the 29th ID in the beaches of Normandy? I believe they were. 116th. Along with the, who were they now again? Some 80 or something. 29th ID began along with the first, of course. But I can't remember who there was. Well, there was a 700 and something Shermans or 300 something Italian. I don't know. I've read basically statistics of this. Like, not like it was literature, but it was basically statistics in like a fluent and a lovely text. What's his name again? Who wrote it? Anthony Beaver or something like that. Beaver or Bever or something like that. Man, what an amazing author. Really good reading if you like World War II. Really just explains everything about everything. They even mentioned the Cameron Highlanders, which is fun, because the Cameron Highlanders were also actually in this war, not fighting for the British, nor of British origin or anything like that. They just wore kilts and called themselves the Cameron Rifles. You know, just because they had the number 79th, nothing else. I mean, welcome to do it, but what if every state did it? Maybe there were a lot of Scottish people in it as well. But, yeah. And they're still standing, you know. And the Union Militia. God, I'm hungry. You heard my roar. Alright, so we have a majority of men over here. They're just going to be sent up this way. And then we have the artillery. It's going to be coming with us. Yet I've yet to see my Napoleon cannons. Just only seen Withwort this far. Are they sending in any more reinforcements? Oh, yes they are. Oh, yes they are, baby. This battle ain't over yet. Ain't over until I say so. Oh, damn. Oh, come on. We move. Come on. We don't move, eh? What's going on, eh? Okay, can we move now? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, we're looking back at this. Looks like we got him. We're gonna charge back into the artillery to the parrot rifles. Looks like they've got me, the hill. That's a good spot for the artillery. Yeah, well, I lost the majority of the quarter in the left flank. What the hell? Seriously? That is nasty. Two of these units. 100 men. Just, nah. Gonna turn my back down and run. And they're still winning. Fuck you. Seriously? That is annoying. And that's probably why they're bringing in more and more cannons there. I wasn't noticing why there were so much artillery. And then I was like, oh, maybe I'm losing a lot of men. Proved to be the answer. Sending these guys up as well. Yet they have failed to die. I wonder if my men are failing to follow orders, or if the enemy's just bloody annoying. Well, they're certainly annoying, nonetheless, but... Did our cavalry do its job? I think it did. It ran away, but it definitely broke off the whole left here. So we got 31st. The first regiment of foot. Doesn't necessarily mean it's good, though. Probably drunk. That is kind of a haggis joke. I don't know what you classify as a haggis stroke. I don't even know what that means or what you refer to that, but I don't know, it's stereotypical. I also have yet to taste haggis. I'll probably do it sometime. Oh, a direct hit. They have like purple pants, aren't they? Oh, well, I guess, aren't they supposed to be like more like, not red, but more like... Wait a minute, I don't recall them having any differently colored pants when I saw Glory. Maybe they're a designer. I would like to have a speak with the tailor of this regiment, to be quite honest. Or speak, a talk. A speak. I want to have a speak. Looks like we've just drained out our whole reserves, have we not? No. Because look at this. If it isn't McWithworth's core coming in with his Withworth cannon. Bloody epic. Coming in from the flank as well. When the Union's retreating. Looks like they've all... Ah, they've moved up in like a big formation like I did. Here's where it comes down to. Just holding your positions. Of course we have our reinforcements coming in here. The glorious, glorious, glorious Excelsior Brigade. Which wasn't even... Oh, they all broke off. They're like, meh,
we took over the sheet. I'm gonna go out of here.
Okay, artillery. That's a shit ton of you. We're gonna place you here. And we're also gonna take this Union regiment, I mean, Confederate regiment, and put it there. Got artillery coming in, we're gonna put that here. Just clearing up the battlefield. Let's swap the shrapnel, and let's see who's the lowest strength right here. I think we're gonna fire in the 11th. Pussies. Oh no, we lost the captain, sir. Ugh. What a bloody day. It's a Thursday today, isn't it? Well, let's say it took place on Thursday. Why not? I'm not a fan of shooting up hills, but I'm forced to. Got engineers here as well. More engineers. A lot of engineers. This is like our engineer corps, hence it's amazing amount of artillery. Oh my god, so much infantry as well. They're just feeding me right now with just infantry.
Forward.
Okay, I'm gonna turn these around slightly. Seems like the Yankees are out of reinforcements. Like they've spent all their cards. Who knows? I might be out as well. You never really know until you stand there with the hands down your pocket and like, I ain't got no reinforcements, sir. I've shit myself, sir. Glorious. And we run to the position as told.
I believe I've got a here.
Go. So are we winning any of it? Yes, we are. So engineers are pretty good in shooting, actually. They probably deployed tons of fancy covers and all that stuff, but nothing that I'm interested in. 116th at Fort Rayleigh. Not quite sure where it ran. They saw the cannons and they're like, oh shit, McDougal's score. Not gonna enter that. Oh, well, I did have more reinforcements. Oh, man. So many lives being lost. 116th regiment of foot. Please. I'm gonna try and do the flanky flank here, which I strongly disagree with. But they're okay with just running past and taking all kinds of casualties. Feels like we shouldn't bring the artillery up much further for that part either. Hence, why I'm gonna stop everything right there. Bring the rest up. What's that? All infantry right here. All right, go there. Artillery, here. Right there. Actually, we'll see. You're deploying. Ah, never mind. Don't do anything then. Are they gonna run out of here? First? I don't think so. They're just putting the poor... Watch them just run past us. Wait a minute. They don't have... Oh, Union collared infantry? But they're collared as well. And they have got... No. Red pants. Doesn't make any difference. Would Shaw treat them differently? Why would anyone treat them differently? Oh, you 1800s. So behind. So out of fashion. I just gotta aim for the Irish Brigade. They brought booze to the battle. I disallow that. Okay, let's bring these guys up here. Hey. These Withwards are only coming two, but I believe they're bloody accurate. Well, a couple of rounds from that, and there were no more. And I believe that that ends the battle. Oh, yes, what a glorious fight. The Union, which can alone ensure internal peace and external security to each state, must determine reserves. Oh my god, what a fight. Oh, what a fight. What a fight. 16,000 men participated in this battle. And god, we lost a lot. 3,352 men died in a matter of an hour, and along with the 4,323 that died. And the Union is forced to retreat. Washington is right now threatened severely. I didn't even think I brought in all my troops. But one thing is sure, I'm going to do a lot of spending on the actual kind of like regaining strength with the troops. But this was one of the best victories we've had. Definitely allows me to take Washington. If I can take Washington, taking Philadelphia and just central New York, or, well, Rochester itself, shouldn't be a problem whatsoever. So it should be interesting. Having that said, I think we're going to wait until the Union's done with the return, and then I think we're going to end this fight. I can barely even speak, hence why I'm cold, or the other way around.
Now this panel is used for negotiations.
Oh my god. Okay, so I've been available attacked by the United Provinces and the Great British joint. Oh my god, this is just lengthening the war so much. And this is so freaking frustrating. At least the British are with us. Let me see if I can't get the British to declare war on the we're just going out of focus here completely. I want them to the
use this option no, to officially no, no, that'd be weird. Money can be offered to or demanded.
They can walk in my territories. Right,
this
I hope
panel
so.
Enables
first of
you
all,
to view
France,
the state of diplomatic relations
you
between nations.
And I.
Select a
we're
nation
go
by
oh,
clicking
okay.
on their flag.
Fuck you, then.
Their allies,
Spain,
enemies,
completely.
And trading. This option is used to broker trade agreements.
Where are you?
Once
United Provinces, you dickheads.
A trade route is opened
peace.
Your nation, and
and I shall give you.
Technology can be offered
you like
to
money, right? I'll give you 4,000 for 5
a
turns.
Deal. A technology can be demanded.
Okay,
as
well,
as
trade agreement with them and a peace treaty,
researched.
And they get 21,000. Yeah, I'm okay with that.
The
they're unfriendly, but I'm.
And those
oh my god! Why did I do that?
As your enemies
fuck!
Were
fuck!
To
fuck! Fuck!
Your
fuck!
Economy.
I just paid 21,000 for absolutely nothing. I thought it would, like, I just clicked it and it canceled it. Oh, why, you fucking stupid game. Piece of shit engine. Oh! Or stupid development mistake by just, like, when I click this, it allows me to do this. So, wouldn't I have to, like, send it? Oh, Jesus Christ. At least I sent them 21,000 for peace, but having a trade agreement would make things so much easier. Why? I'm gonna just brutally fuck this game in the ass. Like, bring a knife and just take up CD and just stab it a million times. Hoping to get somewhat of a pleasure from that. Anyways, we got a new fight coming up where we've apparently got a shit ton of artillery, and that's all. I think I'll avoid it, actually. What?! Oh my god, another one of these fucking dumb bullshit mistakes just occurring in front of me? What is this?
In order to gain control of a
can, I can actually take it. Yes. All right. Well, you see, I paid off.
Following capture of a capital city,
yay.
It is important to leave an adequate garrison behind to quell unrest until both the population level and any damaged buildings are fully restored.
Well, you see,
exempting
bad shit happens, but
may also be helpful in the
something good always happens behind it. You know, something good always comes with everything, or something bad comes with everything, to be precise. But first of all. Time for replenishments.
Yes,
this is probably one of the armies that took the biggest hit. It would be really nice to have a trade agreement with the Dutch. As
sir.
Well, I'd get tons of money.
Orders.
But nope.
Ready.
Instead, I lost all my money. Didn't get anything but peace. And I also lost then like a full stacked army that just randomly walked in there and got killed. See, that's the punishment you get from trying to do your best. Clearly, that's not enough. Anyhow, what is enough is this right now. I've had enough of this right now. I'm gonna end this down. It's been a long video, but we are making progress. And we did actually take Washington, D.C. Casualties aside, they will, well, always be replaced by two more men. One for two. So, gonna go in for Philly. Get some cheese steaks. It'll be a nasty fight nonetheless. Try and even get there, it's gonna be a hell of a fight. But, I'll see you then. Bye.